growing up in New York City and attending a private school like I did, I was able to take coding classes and robotics classes at an early age. However, I did play in inner city basketball, and oftentimes my teammates didn't have the same opportunities as I did. That's one of the reasons why I'm going specifically after urban areas. I am going after inner city kids, BK Brooklyn, similar and very close to where I grew up, to give the kids of this neighborhood and many other urban areas the ability to just walk right in and expand their mind on STEM activities. Hi, I'm Niesha Butler, and I'm the CEO and founder of STEAM Champs. I have a very diverse background. I am a former professional basketball player. I played overseas in Spain and for the New York Liberty. I graduated from Georgia Tech, All-American. I can ball, y'all. In addition to that, I actually worked as a reporter for CBS News and a producer. And after I went back to school to graduate, I became a software engineer. This is my third startup. I love teaching, so I kind of have like the sports, engineering, and of course, a little bit of show business background. I started volunteering as a computer science teacher for Microsoft Teals and in Atlanta, and I found that a couple things. My presence, representation really means a lot to kids. Just to see someone that looks like them doing something that I guess they're not told when they're young that they can do is really important. Also, I noticed that there's a lot of jobs, high-paying jobs, that are open and available. And I feel like, obviously, someone is trained as an engineer, any kind of job as a STEM, they can do it. So seeing that there was a disparity in like a connection or a pipeline between the children in New York or the children in inner cities that live under and around the poverty line to these jobs, I'm trying to figure out like how can we make this connection? And me being a software engineer, I knew that if I came from the inner city and I can be an engineer, so could other young kids. So STEAM Champs is a kids coding, robotics, arts STEAM center. STEAM stands for science, technology, engineering, arts, and math. So we have kids play games and learn how to build them all at the same time. Coming from an athletic background, we definitely put kids into a championship mindset. They have to work in teams, they have to complete projects. You don't get a trophy here by just coming. You compete in my educational center, and you learn all while having fun. So that's what I'm bringing to STEAM Champs, and I hope to bring it to the masses and kids everywhere, that they can learn, have fun, compete, and hopefully be the next generation of STEM professionals. We have a couple of tracks. We have a robotics tracks. We go from 5 to 7, 7 to 9, and 9 to 12 is that we're focused on right now. We teach kids how to program and build the robots and go through missions. We use a lot of Lego robotics, a lot of lower cost robots as well, so that kids can purchase them, practice at home. The idea is really to have an environment where kids can be creative. They can work together and they can learn things. And when they come across bumps, they can figure it out. We also have a coding track, and the idea is to really kind of massage kids into being software engineers and or coding, but also just to give them a basic foundation of coding. I feel like that is the future, and the younger a kid starts to understand coding, which is a language, the better off they will be in any field that they choose. And we also include arts. I think it's really important to include arts because especially in urban communities, like, we thrive and we create culture, and that comes a lot from the art space. So I feel like if we can cultivate these kids younger and teach them technical skills as well, we can support those kids as well into STEM professionals. So that's what we do. It's really important for parents to get behind the nerdy kid, to get behind the kid who wants to tinker with things and build things. I'm doing my part. Like, we're here, we're coming to you, we're making it affordable. We need to change the narrative of what we pay for and what we feel like it's important for kids. If kids can go and get up at 5 o'clock in the morning, or New York City courts when I was growing up were filled with kids playing basketball, which I love sports, and sports is very important as far as growth as well to a child. We need to get behind these kids that like games. We need to get behind gamers. Technology is the future. And our community the most is gonna be hit hardest if we're not equipping our kids with these necessary skills. So we're here. And I feel, and I always say, I am very confident that all the kids that come through my program, if they choose to have a career in STEM, they will go pro. I cannot say that for a basketball. I think it's under 1% of kids that actually play basketball in America have the opportunity to even go pro. And if they do go pro, it's about on average a 4-year career. We're building STEAM champions for the future that we can actually get kids out of generational poverty with one job. Six figures, guys, is what these software engineers, data scientists, statisticians are making. So one of the real special, I guess, something's really close to my heart of building something like this, right where I grew up, is to give kids opportunities to work. You know, our internships to be mentoring. I don't find, I know I certainly didn't have a lot of opportunities growing up in STEM careers that can intern, you know, at 16, 17 years old to see a person build, you know, a multi-million dollar STEM engineering company. I really go after rock stars. My interns are rock stars. They have interest in STEM field. And I was actually surprised how they're not supported. You know, we have an intern that's on a National Honor Society, and in their public school that they attend, wasn't supported to go after engineering or a STEM career. So I'm not only giving them, we do pair interns, an opportunity to have a job, but I want to prepare them so that the next year, the year after, when they apply to Bloomberg, Microsoft, or a Google job, they have some job experience to put on their resume other than McDonald's or something else, which I think that's important, that they can just easily take the train. I'm easily accessible. I don't only hire my interns with people that just workers or employees. I hire them as far as like a mentorship. I wish this was available when I was younger, just to give them, even if they don't have certain skills or certain things in the beginning, I really believe that there's something there. So I think it's really important for kids to have opportunities like this so that they can grow and flourish. I think there are two things that I want kids to take away from this program. The first point that what I'm building here is for the community and of the community that they can do it. You know, entrepreneurship is a tough road. And when you think of engineering and STEM and big tech companies, you do, and I do, think of like a Bill Gates or a Steve Jobs or Elon Musk. But now I want them to think of Niesha Butler. I want to think of any of the kids' names that, you know, are in our program, a Sanaya Butler, a Pharrell Brown, a Charlie Odorelli, whatever their names are that are a part of our community, I want them to think that they can have that. They can have a business, they can start an idea and make it from an idea to an actual physical product. The next thing is skills. We're building champions here and I want them to grow. I want in the next 10, 20 years, and hopefully I can be a partner with other companies that they recognize the students that are a part of STEAM Champs are high performing students that are, you know, STEM professionals of the future, and that we can guide them for careers. I'm trying to build champions that go out there and to take over the world. We not only are teaching them fundamental coding skills and robotics and programming languages, but every kid that STEAM Champs touch, I want them to walk with the vibe that I walked off when I walked on the court. You know, I want them to walk with that confidence. Oftentimes when I was building my tech company, I was the only woman and person of color in the room. Obviously, in this center, that's not the case. But I want them to leave here with the vibe, the confidence, and the skill set to do whatever it is that they want to do, and also know that tech, there's a place for us. And I'm a perfect example of that is true. Being the first Afro-Latina STEAM educational center in the US, it's a lot of responsibility, and it's also a lot of pride. The fact that I'm able to state that with confidence, and we have an awesome program and kids and the community behind us, is something that I pride myself in. I'm working, as we all know, in our household, we gotta be 10 to 20 times better, and I'm okay with that. And I wanna not only be the first, but the one of many to come. And I want to set that, you know, this stage. I want to kind of, you know, trailblaze ahead with what we can make and create here. It's real important that I am the first Afro-Latina STEM educational center in America, because oftentimes tech fields and the tech area seems like it doesn't have a place for us. And I'm here to tell you that it does. And we're busting through the doors.